So in today's video, I'm going to show you a simple little trick that in my opinion makes a huge difference, and I do this to most of my photos, and it's basically just to remove the distraction and clean up the photo. Yo, 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 Karlafretta. My name is Arnar Lund, I'm a photographer from Iceland. So I've touched on this subject before in the past, but I feel that now I can explain it like way better. Plus, you know, the background is more nice. And I've been getting a few questions about this, so I think like it's a good opportunity tonight, today, you know, to show this. So basically what I do, I like to establish like things that are not serving the purpose of the photo. So here you can see we have Oscar right here. He is obviously the like subject of the photo. I want the main attention to like go on him. And in the background, I have some like signs and some things that are like popping out that I do not like. So in the end, I removed it and it looked like this. And to me, this looks like much cleaner and much more nice. Now, when I've talked about this before, I've gotten some comments, people saying like, this is not street photography. You're ruining street photography. You're doing graphic design. To be honest, I honestly don't care. This looks very good to me. And the other type of street photography was more like social documentation. That looks also good to me. Just, you know, do whatever looks good to you. If you don't like this, then don't watch. But if you do, this is a good way to make, you know, your photos a little bit more clean and streamlined. So the way I do this, I either use Lightroom or Photoshop. Both have pros and cons, and I'm going to show you both. So when in Lightroom, you can basically click here the spot removal tool. And then if we zoom in here on something like this, you can basically just drag it down like so. And Lightroom is gonna like remove this here. And you can see that it's kind of gone now. And especially like if we zoom out, it doesn't really show anymore. Now I've made a whole video about the spot removal tool if you want like really dive deep into how it works. I'll link it up here because there are a few things within the spot removal tool that I think is like essential to understand. For instance, you have clone and heal, and what's the difference there? I covered it all in this video and I'm not gonna do it here, so this is not gonna take forever. Anyways, the thing with the spot removal tool is that it's not nearly as good as in Photoshop. So where I use the spot removal tool is on basically just like small spots and smaller things. For example, here I have a photo. This is very much out of focus. I did this in with a like old vintage lens, but where I'm removing like this small spots and stuff, the spot removal tool is perfect. Then I'm just like clicking here and boom, it's gone. And you can do this anywhere you like. Where it's not nearly as good is, for instance, on bigger things like here, like a whole car or whatever. It's not nearly as good as in Photoshop. So you can see that this looks a little bit weird right now. And I think this is not nearly as good. And in situations like this, I would jump down to Photoshop. Now the reason I don't go to Photoshop straight away is that it's a little bit hassle, you know, changing programs. So if I can, if I see just like small things, I do the spot removal tool and remove as much as I can. Now this is a tedious process. It takes a whole lot of time because you're like zooming in, finding a small spot, removing it, and it takes a whole lot of time. But in the end, I think the end result is totally worth it. So if we go to Photoshop from here, all you have to do is just to right click on the photo and then you go to edit in and open in Adobe Photoshop. Boom. And then it's gonna open up in the Photoshop. Okay, so once you're in Photoshop, you have two different tools you can work with. You can work with the stamp tool. So if you press S on your keyboard, you have a tool called the stamp tool. So if we zoom in here, let me see, we zoom in right like this. And we make the stamp tool bigger, like so. So basically how the stamp tool works is like this. If you hold in Alt on PC, it's like, what, Option on Mac or something. You can choose any space you want to copy and paste on top of anything else. So for instance, if I choose this spot here, now I pick this spot and I can then paste it on top of this, like so. And now I've like kind of removed this space, place. And for instance here, we can go like this. And then we can paste this over here, creating a little extra tree here. Okay, now if you go up here, you can change the hardness of the stamp and then of course the size of the stamp, how big you want it to be. Now there is another tool also that you can use, and that is the lasso tool. So if you click L on your keyboard, you get a lasso like this. What you can do now is basically that you can take and like go around the car like this, and then you press delete on your keyboard, delete, and make sure that you have content aware and press okay. What happens now? Photoshop is just gonna do a little bit of magic and boom, the car is removed. Now the beautiful thing is, to me, when these are things that are this far away in the background, it does not have to be perfect. You see, if we like zoom out here again, you can now see that this could fly by. So usually what I do this in combination. I usually take the lasso tool and I remove some things, like let's say I remove this here, boom, and we remove it. If it's not perfect, now this was totally perfect, but if it was not perfect, I then click S, I make the stamp a little bit smaller, and I start to like cleaning up the thing that was not perfect the first time with the lasso tool. Now, one thing about the lasso tool is that when you're removing like big objects, I think it's better to do them in like few portions instead of doing all at the same time. For instance, we have this here. I think this is like fairly distracting. Then instead of going like and removing everything like so, I'm just doing this fast, okay? I would do this better and spend more time on it if I was not doing a tutorial for you guys. So here, this is a little bit strange. I could go in here and like zoom in and start with the, you know, stamp tool and drum. But what I would do instead, I would do like this and I would just start to move this like so. Okay, maybe this portion first, delete, and then I would move on to the next, like so. Now, as I said, this is a tedious job, and this specific place is a little bit hard, but with the lasso tool in combination with the stamp tool, I can easily remove it. But it takes a little time and it's a damn tedious. But let's do it. So as you can see now, I'm basically just, you know, taking things here and building up the stair again by like copying this spot on here, and then I'm removing everything else just like so. Okay, now as I said earlier, because these things are all, you know, things in the background, you don't have to do this like totally perfect. And you can see here that this totally flies by. I could spend a little more time, and I did that on the photo I posted to make it even better. But like this took me just a few minutes and boom, it's gone. And the further away things are, the, you know, less perfect they have to be. Let's finish this, okay? And basically what I'm doing, I'm constantly like zooming out, looking at the photo and thinking like, okay, what is not enhancing the photo? What is like taking the attention from the main subject? And often to me, it's like these bright little signs or things that are like pop out that I don't want to pop out. And then basically I remove it. And I can see here then back there, we have some red things here I'm going to take out. So then I just like zoom back on it like this. And I can easily just like go, it does not have to be perfect. Boom, and take it away. Okay, now, once I'm happy and I want to go back to Lightroom, a simple way to like jump back to Lightroom is to press Ctrl and W and then save this. And it's gonna open up as a TIFF file within Lightroom. Okay, so here I am back in Lightroom. Now you have a fresh photo that is a TIFF file, and you can see this is what we did now. And like just on this small time, we've removed a bunch of things. And my final photo, it went from being like this, as you can see, to this here. And as you can see here, I spent a little more time on the stairs, and this looks good to me. If I now want to do some final adjustments, I do that, and then I just export the photo. All right, so that is it. If you like this video, please smack that like button for me. It really helps me out. This is a little tip I learned from Evan Rams like way, way, way back. And I really much like it. I think it really like cleans up the photos and makes them look like pretty much like streamlined and nice. Now, if you have any questions, as always, feel free to ask in comments down below. Let me know what you thought about this. Is this something you like, or are you like more like, no, I want to have things, you know, more real and pure. That's also totally okay. Like when in the like realm of photography, this is just art. And to me, create whatever you like. And yeah, that's the message of the day. Create whatever you like. I'll catch you guys in the next video. I'm out. Peace.